continuing our team coverage when it comes to finding out about these cases of COVID-19. Well, there's a delay, and it's causing frustration for many of you with the lack of answers that we're getting. NBC2's Jessica Babb asked Lee County leaders why it's taken so long to bring these cases to light.
If the cases came in on Wednesday and the person passed away on Thursday, why were we not notified sooner? Why did it wait until Friday evening to be told that these cases were in Lee County, especially since on Thursday I spent hours making phone calls to the Department of Health and the hospital trying to get this information?
While some Lee County leaders are calling for more transparency, Jessica Babb is live at Gulf Coast Medical Center with how the government is now handling these cases.
On Thursday, I spent hours directly asking officials if there were any cases of COVID-19 right here in Lee County, but wasn't given any answers. It wasn't until late last night they told us about those two confirmed cases. And we weren't the only ones left in the dark. The governor and other elected officials also didn't know about it then until then either. And now they say there needs to be more communication in cases like this.
We're all for patient safety and protecting people's privacy, but the public also has a right to know what's going on in their community.
Today in a press conference, Lee Health confirming two cases of COVID-19 in Lee County. Both people went to the hospital on Wednesday. One of them, a woman in her 70s, died Thursday morning. But there was no confirmed information from health officials about this until late Friday night.
Would we have liked to have known even earlier? Sure, absolutely.
Florida Governor Ron DeSantis didn't even know about the cases until around 5 p.m. Friday, after holding a press conference.
I think giving information and being as transparent as possible is always the best policy.
Hospital and Florida Department of Health officials say they couldn't tell us if people are being monitored or have been tested in the area because of privacy reasons. Health officials say it's not until after a COVID-19 case is confirmed we can get any info about it.
One of my big frustrations is that the Department of Health has to be so tight-lipped about information regarding who the patient was, where the patient has been since they've been in town.
Health officials also say they can't confirm how many other people in our area may have been exposed.
That could not be more wrong. That's everyone needs to know, so that you can take whatever precautions you feel necessary.
In fact, there's nothing in place requiring a hospital to inform the Department of Health if there's been a patient who's died before test results come back.
I think a lot of those details, if they were more forthcoming with them, would give people a sense of comfort so that people would know how to govern themselves accordingly.
Commissioner Brian Hammond and Governor DeSantis say they'd like to see communication in these cases get better.
And I'd like to see more information come out as we can get it out so that people can understand the situation more.
And they say they'll be looking into it to see if any changes need to be made.
You've got to really be careful, obviously, to protect patient privacy, but you can't let that trump the need to get out good factual information so that the public can make their decisions based on facts and not fear.
And we also did talk with the sheriff today. He echoes that same sentiment. As for any plans moving forward, there's no concrete plans if any changes will be made at this time. Reporting live in Fort Myers, Jessica Babb, NBC2.